I want to thank those of you who are still here in our audience. You know, thank you for sticking with us all day. I think it was super exciting, but you show you have true audience stamina, because this has been long, even though it's super exciting. I also want to thank the speakers and the moderators who helped us out by getting this conversation going. As I said, I think it's a conversation. We need to continue it outside and beyond this. Thank you especially to our hardworking staff, Casey, Mads, Vanessa, Janina, and Shayna, who really helped pull this off. I really want to thank my co-organizer, Michele. This was her vision. She really pushed this through with lots of ups and downs organizationally over the last year, and it turned out, I think, beautifully. And then I wanted to make one comment on the content of what I heard today. And Michele, I think, is going to wrap up with a little more. But I heard, really, from many of the speakers, and I think I heard it more explicitly in Enongo's comments, that one thing we need to do, I think, to create truly human-centered AI is that we as designers and technologists have to consider power and take on power in how we're designing these systems. Many of the different topics, power, I think, is coming up either explicitly or implicitly, and we need to really consider that. And this is something that technologists often just ignore and pretend that's not their problem. And so I think that is something really a lot of this has to be thought about, not just for art and creativity, but for making AI systems that are human-centered and have positive impact. So I'm going to leave it there, and Michele will take us to the next part.
Very sure. Thank you, James. Mine is literally 1.5 minutes, because I know we're really short of time. And I want to thank, look, they're still talking over there. I love it. They, like, can't even stop. This is so absolutely thrilling for me. Let me put up one. I just have two very short slides. Oops, this is not the one. This is not the one. There we go. Got to always bring Baldwin in the house. So several of the sessions today have emphasized the value of honoring the histories and knowledge systems informing the present as necessary to create our futures. And as many of our panelists mentioned too, there's an ahistoricity to the conversations about AI often. And that means recognizing the racialized social values that tech encodes and reproduces. And I wanted to bring that up because, of course, it echoes also with what Baldwin is saying, too. And it also puts the light of the notion that tech is just a neutral tool. I also just wanted to end with, how do I go back? Okay, wait. I don't know. It's a tech. Okay. I wanted to emphasize the value of slow tech, actually, because, yes, AI seems to outpace understanding, regulation, even life's rhythms, but we might keep in mind the insight of the 19th century intellect, Henry Adams, who witnessed with dismay how the brand new invention at the time, this giant dynamo, as it was known, that could produce electricity at scale for the first time, so gobsmacked the audience at the Great Exposition at the Paris World's Fair in 1900, where it was demonstrated with a lot of pomp and circumstance by the sitting president himself, that no one bothered checking out the arts exhibits that formerly held the audience's attention, or pretty much looked at anything else. And it wasn't just the art, it was actually the world itself, Adams writes, that seemed less significant, less worthy in the presence of this over awe-inspiring, exhilarating, but intimidating new technology. It was as if, he said, the dynamo held higher truth, represented some near divinity, calling for our supplication and subordination. And he pondered the risks of humans genuflecting before their own creations, and resisted the idea, popular today still, that technological development always equals some inexorable, ever-escalating progress that we poor selves must constantly try to catch up with. It's a time when size, speed, scale, optimization are all the incantations of the day, and it's something you hear about constantly. I've told everyone keeps coming up, I'm exhausted, you can't keep up. We hope this symposium has encouraged the pause, a bit of a slowdown. It introduced some friction, a moment of critical reflection, a chance to take a breath and a beat. And yes, we have panels and sessions, but we also know that it may well be the smaller chance moments of people having conversations in the corners or in the halls. I had a few in the bathroom, you know, over good food and even better drink that are maybe even more valuable chances to co-create more spacious, more generous, more joyful. Somebody said ennobling, love that. even more interesting ways of being with themselves and each other and with our planetary kin. I'm going to introduce the concluding performance by Enongo, Lumumba-Kasongo, who, as you know, is assistant professor on music and AI and hip-hop, who spoke brilliantly earlier. She's also known for her rap as Samus, so she not only talks about the scholarly intersections of hip-hop and AI, she's performed them, and she generously is closing out our day with a couple short pieces. Please welcome her.
Hello, hello. Okay, I know everyone's hungry and tired, so I would love if we could just take a deep breath collectively. So if we could just inhale and exhale. Doesn't that feel great? Okay, so I'm gonna take my shoes off. So I'm gonna do two pieces for you. The first is a song about losing my mind in grad school and how art saved my life. So thank you for your commentary earlier about the stakes of this work, the stakes for artists, about how it's sustaining, that having pride in the work that you do is enough to pull someone out of bed when they might feel like there are no other possibilities. So this piece is called 1080p from my grad school days. And you can start the track. Oh, I'm pretending this is a dive bar right now and not my usual setting. Yeah. I'm kinda scared of the academy. I think that my parents are proud of me. I just wish I knew how to be comfortable here. I never feel like I'm allowed to breathe, rubbing shoulders with these old nerds, rocking sweater vests in their office hours, eating hors d'oeuvres while I soul search, trying to make some sense of the ivory tower, feeling sober. Am I just a coward or a poser? I don't really doubt it, or a soldier, books and holsters, but the setting sucks. I can't fight the power cause they write books. Nobody reads for these white folks that they trying to please. Recycle all the right quotes, trying to cite blokes, ain't my cup of tea, eating Chex Mix, feeling helpless. I really miss my fucking ex, is such a mind fuck, cause we never talk, yet we still share a fucking Netflix. And every day I apologize to the poor kid that we never had. The emotion of the whole thing make me so sick. It's fucking sad. What you don't get is how focused that I had to be, cause you couldn't provide. Mad at me cause I'm losing my mind. Had to leave at a terrible time. Prednisone, I could barely breathe. Now the pressure gone, I barely sleep. I ring the phone, but you don't respond. Had to put myself in some therapy. Now my therapist, she take care of me. Yeah. Like Sierra Miss, things are clear to see. Huh. Now I'm seeing my world in 1080p, baby. Yeah. Now I'm seeing my world in 1080p, my mother.
Give me a call when you can. I hope you're doing fine. Well, considering the situation, but at least there's clarity on certain things. You have explanation of the strange, unusual behavior.
It's been a few months since the last verse, since I called you bad words. I went ahead and got my master's. I trimmed the last of my relaxers, so my fro big, got some mo gigs. My cell phone says I'm roaming cause I'm on tour. I want more, forget home so I go big. I was taking pills up in the bathroom. Ended up alone in grad school. I'm Mario, I busted ass, but my prize is sitting in another castle. In a tight spot trying to disappear, I would write songs for my friends to hear. I'm trying to keep my lights on. I'm a Nikon. Now it's crystal clear. Opportunity is at my doorstep. So I'm moving back up on the horse like it's the first time I ever wore specs. I do my thing like life's a Rorschach. I see things nobody sees since my bee stings turn to double D's. I'm conceding that my feelings is amazing. Now I'm loving me. I could give it up, but where's the fun in that? Gotta live it up or you will never laugh. Life's a box of chocolates with a lot of options. Gotta keep it rocking like a rumble pack. The first letter of your first name makes your name emerge when I search things, and it hurts me, but I guarantee that without you, I'm a better me. And now I see the past with some clarity. Thank God I took my ass to some therapy. Now I'm seeing my world in 1080p. Now I'm seeing my world in 1080p. I got one more for y'all. Thank you. So, so the second piece is a response to the first piece that I wrote maybe 5 or 6 years later, because I had been defined by that song. People kept talking to me about that first song. People interviewed me about that first song. They wanted me to perform that first song all the time, and I wanted to resist that. I wanted to speak about something else. I wanted to talk about the joy that I felt in creating, that even though I was broken, and I continued to be broken, creativity was this beautiful thing that enabled me to show up in life in spaces I was told I was never supposed to exist within. So this piece is called Two Hands, which I think is funny because AI struggles with hands, and it's just about how incredible it is that we get to make things. I mean, what a gift. So you can play the track. Ooh, my nerves. Funny to ponder how I am stressed when, like Flenny, my problems are coming from iOS. Many of us come from violence or happen to die for less or wind up a nihilist with a fire like Kylo Ren's. Yeah, even though my body chronically fails, I got a doc who can prescribe me some anxiety pills. Got a writer on my side, it's like we Sonic and Tails. Yeah, baby, I'ma be alright, and when I gotta pay bills, well, you can see me running to the bank to my savings. People give me money just to think and to say things. Amazing. We got a roof for our scalp, a booth for my mouth, and a sink for our shavings. I know it's often like creating is hazing. When you're under pressure, your brain sings. But whether you put brushes to paintings or somebody plucking them bass strings, it's a fucking blessing to make things. Ah, with these two hands and a broken mind, I'ma hold my lanes, whether broke or fine. I'm naked and alive. Yeah. With these two hands and a broken heart, I'ma hold my lens like I'm Joan of Arc. I'm naked in life. Yes. Grateful I could spar with anyone on any BPMs. I could spit a bar like the legend of Prometheus, descended from Olympus, doper than Olympics. I deliver fire that be leaven in the plebeians, but it ain't always easy making heat on the beat pad. I just could believe and I can't be mad. I ain't checking in the past, fuck a screen grab. Look into the future, yeah, my focus 2020 like a C-Lab. Gotta keep tabs on my own perspective, or I'ma relapse if I don't protect it. Everybody doing fine, everybody online, behind the keyboards, many souls neglected. Put up in this place just to write dope lines, run deeper in my veins than my vital signs. When my rider dies, give me waves, they be fanning the flames of this little light of mine, and I'ma let it shine forever until I die. Oh! Yeah, with these two hands and a broken mind, I'ma do my days, whether broke or fine. I'm a work of art. Naked in life. Thank you all so much. Yeah. Grateful for my life. I'm grateful to you all for everything you've given today.
Making all this life. Naked in life.
Thank you. Thank you.